Welcome students to session number 43 of chapter number 5, that is laws of motion. Today is the revision session we to have, and today we are going to discuss few topics that are already been discussed into depth. The very first topic that we are going to discuss today is linear momentum. Now we already know what is that is linear momentum. Linear momentum is nothing but what? It is the measure of motion possessed by the body. Motion possessed by the body is known as what? Linear momentum. So you can define as linear momentum is defined as the amount of motion possessed by the body. Clear? Is known as linear momentum. Linear momentum can also be defined, it is already known to you, that is the product of mass into velocity. So you can write linear momentum is the product of mass and velocity. Now we already know what is scalar form of momentum. Scalar form, if you want to write, then scalar form I can write P is equal to what? Mv. And if somebody asks me the vector form, P is vector, yes. Mass scalar, P vector, yes. So my vector form is P is equal to Mv. Remember your thing, why linear momentum is vector? Because velocity is vector, so product of velocity means vector into scalar is going to be a vector, means linear momentum is a vector quantity. So I can write over here linear momentum is a vector quantity, and direction of P will be same as that of what? V. Direction of linear momentum is going to be same as that of the direction of velocity. So you can write over here the direction of linear momentum is same as that of the direction of velocity. Very good. Direction of velocity. Till this clear? Now if somebody asks you the unit for this, if I ask you SI unit, so SI unit we need P is equal to MV, means mass is kg, yes or no, velocity is meter per second, so unit will be what, kg meter per second. If somebody asks you the CGS unit for P, CGS P is equal to MV, mass is measured in CGS, coming grams, very good, velocity centimeter per second. So my unit is gram centimeter per second. If somebody asks you the dimensional formula for this same, then dimensional formula we would able to define is the equation is what? Mass, so m1, length, so l1, second, so t minus 1. This is my dimensional formula for what? Linear momentum. Hope it is clear, the basic concept of linear momentum. Clear? Now moving ahead, in order to know the few different cases by considering two objects and their variation with momentum. Clear? So we are going to study the next topic. Now we are going to study variation of momentum. Variation of momentum we are going to study. Now see, the variation word is over here. Variation. If I want to study variation of something, you need to know that we need to compare with among two things. Then only I would be able to know what is the variation, what is the similarity, what is dissimilarity, what type of conclusion in order to derive. Yes. So I am considering over here. Consider. I am teaching you case one first. Consider two objects. Consider two objects of similar masses, we can consider M moving with velocities, moving with velocities v1 and v2 respectively. V1 and v2 respectively. 100% clear? There are two objects you can consider. There is an object m moving with velocity v1. As another object m moving with velocity v2. Condition is v1 greater than v2. V1 greater than v2 means what? V1 faster and this is your slower. Can this clear? We know the equation for the momentum. P is equal to what? P1 mass is m, velocity is v1. P2 mass is m, velocity is v2. Clear? Comparing P1 by P2, if I want to calculate P1 by P2 is the thing, but m V1 by m V2, mm cut, the answer is V1 by V2. From here I got one thing. What I got one thing? P1 by P2, very good, is equal to V1 by V2. Clear? From here I can conclude this. See, this is P1, this is V1. So I can conclude that P is proportional to V provided m is constant. M is constant. If P1 is increasing, V1 is increasing. If P2 is decreasing, V2 is decreasing. If P2 is increasing, V2 is increasing. Or if P1 is decreasing, V1 is decreasing. Clear till this? So I can draw a graph over here. That is momentum versus velocity will be a straight line. If velocity increases, momentum increases. But condition over here is what? Mass is constant. Mass is constant. P versus V graph I am plotting over here. I will be able to notice one thing. As soon as I am increasing V, as and when I am increasing V, P is increasing, but mass is constant. This is the nature of what? Graph. This is case 1 graph. Figure of case 1. Is this clear? I have taken two objects of similar masses, that is M, moving with velocity, different velocities, V1 and V2, provided V1 is greater than V2. And I have get the equation that P is proportional to V. Remember, if V1 is greater than V2, P1 by P2 we are going to get as V1 by V2. If V1 is greater than V2, then P1 is greater than V2. P1 is greater than V2. Till this clear? Fine. Moving to the next case, that is case number 2. That is case number 2. We are moving to case number 2. For the case number 2, we are going to study as consider two objects of different masses. Remember, in the previous case, I have taken two objects of same mass. Here are different masses, m1 and m2 respectively. Moving with velocities. Now I am taking same velocity. Moving with same velocity. And that same velocity is V I am considering. So I am going to get my equation P1. P is equal to M. From that I can get P1, that is equal to mass is M1. Velocity is V. And from P is equal to MV, I can get again equation P2, that is equal to M2V. If I can take that we can consider over here M1 is greater than M2. Means M1 is heavier than M2. Till this clear? M1 is heavier than M2. Hope it is clear till this? Fine. So moving ahead, if I want to take the ratio, that is P1 by P2, that is equal to M1V divided by M2V. This V is cancelled. So I am going to get P1 by P2, that is equal to what? M1 by M2. Here you can see conclusion. P1 is proportional to what? You can say M. Condition is what? V need to be what? Constant. V need to be constant. If somebody gives me to plot the graph, so I can plot the graph like this. P versus M. If M increases, P increases straight line, but condition is what? V constant. V constant. This is my figure 2. Till this clear? Figure 4-2. Here one conclusion. Momentum is proportional to mass provided velocity remains constant. This is my case 2, where momentum will remain same as per what? If velocity is constant. And here I can say if M1 is greater than M2, so I can write P1 is greater than P2, as M1 is greater than M2, and P is proportional to M provided V is constant. Is this clear? Perfectly? 100% clear? If mass is more, momentum is more. Suppose if I want to tell you one thing, that you are having two objects with you, one is stone and one is same size of football. Out of these two, which will take more effort to change its state? Tell me, football or stone? The answer is stone. Very good. Because if you kick the football, it's going to fly easily. Why? Lighter weight, velocity more. Yes or no? Here, more weight, less velocity. So effort will be more in order to move the stone or same size of football rather than football. Till this clear? 100% clear? Okay, moving to the case 3, that is. In the third case we are going to see, that is. Case 3 we are going to see. In case 3 we are going to take one thing, that is two objects having equal linear momentum. Means the momentum is equal. Third case we are going to see, first mass same, velocity different. Second mass different, velocity same. Now third momentum same. I am considering, consider two objects having same linear momentum. Clear? And if you want to check this, means P1 is equal to what? P2. We know that P1 is equal to M1 V1, P2 is equal to M2 V2, because here there are two objects having different masses, different velocities. Different masses is M1, M2. Different velocities V1, V2. So P1 is equal to M1, V1. P2 is equal to M2, V2. If somebody takes me to the ratio that P1 by P2, that is equal to M1, V1 upon M2, V2. And they have said that these two are equal. So this is 1. So 1 is equal to M1, V1 divided by M2, V2. So I am going to get my answer M1, V1, that is equal to M2, V2. If I take the ratio M1 by M2, M1 by M2, that is V2 by V1. You'll be able to notice one thing over here. If mass is of first particle, then velocity of second particle. From here you can notice that m is inversely proportional to 1 upon v. This is given by what? M is inversely proportional to 1 upon v. Or you can say the velocity of the particle is inversely proportional to its mass over here. Clear? So from here you can conclude that if two objects having equal momentum, their velocities are inversely, from here I can write V proportional to 1 upon M also. I'll send this side. Clear? So I can write velocities are inversely proportional to the mass. Clear? So if the two objects have equal momentum, their velocities are inversely proportional to their mass. Is this clear? If somebody asks me to plot the graph, so I can plot the graph of what? M versus V. Your graph will be like this, provided your momentum is what? P constant. Inversely proportional graph is like this. Exponential curve is known as exponential curve. This shows that if one quantity increases, other decreases. Hope it is clear perfectly. Now moving to the few MCQs that I have given in the yesterday's assignment, I am going to solve over here in the revision session in order to make your picture clear. Clear? The first MCQ we do have, that is, fine, we are moving to the fifth MCQ, in which their position is given PT plus QT square plus RT cube, where P is 3 meter per second, Q 4 meter per second square, R 5 meter per second cube, and they are asking force at 2 seconds. Now first thing to be kept into mind, that is, force is nothing but what? Mass into acceleration. Clear? Mass I already have, I need to find out what? Acceleration over here. Then I can calculate F. Now we know that acceleration, first I need to velocity, V is equal to what? Dx by dt. Therefore d by dt of what is x? Pt plus qt square plus rt cube. Is this clear? First d by dt of what? Pt. Next d by dt of qt square. And third d by dt of is what? Rt cube. Is this clear? I have given separation, that is Pt, Qt square, Rt cube. Now PQR is constant, so I can remove P out, and it is dt by dt, then Q out, dt square by dt, and third R is out, dt cube by dt. Is this clear? I have already told you that d by dx of x raised to n, the power n, and you have to reduce one power like this. Suppose if I ask you d by dx of x cube, then you will write 3x, it will reduce one power, that is 2. The same way I apply over here, dt dt is 1, so p into 1, q that is 2t, I have reduced one power, r this is 3t square. So my answer is p plus 2qt plus 3rt square. Till this clear perfectly? This is my v. But I need to find a. A is again not what rate of change of velocity, that is dv by dt. Yes or no? So I will put d by dt, or what is v over here? P plus 2qt plus 3rt square. So again I will put d by dt, that is of p, d by dt of 2qt and d by dt of 3rt square. So this is constant, so 0, 2q out, dt by dt, here 3r out, dt square by dt. Will this clear? You are going to get 0 plus 2q. This dt dt is nothing but 1, 3r, here this is nothing but 2t. Clear? So answer is your 2q plus 6rt. 2q plus 6rt. Now if somebody asks you acceleration in 2 seconds, then you have to put just 2 over r. At instead of t, you have to put 2. The answer is 2q plus 12r. My answer is 2q plus 12r. Till this clear? Now I have to just put it into the values. You are going to get, what you are going to get? I have got already a with me. Yes or no? Here mass is provided to the us, and that mass is how much? 2 kg given. So I can find out a 2 seconds also, I can get it. I have already got the value for A, that is 2. Q is how much? 4 and 12. R is how much? 5. So my answer is 8 plus 60. So answer is 68 meter per second square. This is my value. Now I'll put into the equation. F is equal to MA. Mass is 2, 68. Clear? 136 Newton is my answer. 136 Newton is my answer. Hope it is cleared perfectly. Very well cleared. Moving to the next MCQ we do have with us today, that is, the very next question we do have with us, that is, there is a cricket ball with us, whose mass is 150 grams, and there are two velocities that are provided. This is your u, that is denoted by letter what? Initial velocity is denoted by letter u, yes or no? And final velocity is denoted by letter v. Till this clear? 100% clear? Now they are asking change in momentum. Now see, before I move to the numerical, I have one trick, that is change in moment. Trick in the sense, I want to calculate what exactly I need to calculate. Change in momentum is nothing but change in any quantity is nothing but final minus initial of that quantity. So this is nothing but what? Final momentum minus initial momentum. Yes or no? Yes sir. So final momentum is equal to mass into final velocity. Initial momentum is mass into initial velocity, that is u. Final velocity is v. So if I will take out common, I need to calculate v minus u. This is my final answer for change in momentum. Clear? Now I want to calculate v minus u. V minus u. See, this I and j represents what? The unit vectors for various coordinates. I'll tell you that there are three axes. Yes or no? In geometry, x-axis, y-axis and z-axis. For x axis you are having unit vector, that is I cap, y, j cap, z, k cap. Sir, what is unit vector? Unit vector is a vector whose magnitude is 1. Unit means 1. Clear? The vector whose magnitude is 1 is known as unit vector. For x we are writing I, for y we are writing j, and for z we are writing k. So v minus j, I want to calculate. V is how much? If I send this, is minus 3i minus 4j. Sir, I am sending minus inside. Minus u. U is what? Bracket 3i plus 4j. So I am going to get the answer minus 3i minus 4j. Minus 3i minus 4j. Ii you can add. Minus 3 minus 3 is minus 6i. Jj you can get minus 4 minus 4 is minus 8 unit meter per second. Till this clear? Simply put in this equation, we are going to do that. Mass is given 150 grams. Will not work. 150 by 100. 1000. That means going to be kg. 1010 cut. Yes or no? The answer is how much? 0.15 kg. Yes? 1000 grams is equal to 1 kg. So my mass I got. So I have change in momentum I can get is as change in momentum. If somebody asks me to calculate, that is 0.15 into minus 6i minus 8z. Here, first multiply by 0.15 into minus 6, that is 0.9, I think so. 15 6z, this is 90. 90 divided by 100, that is 0.9, minus 0.9i. Minus 0.15 into 0.8, 5z are 40, 120. It's 120 over here. 15 8z, 5z are 44 carry, 8 and 4 is 12. So 120 by 100, that is 0.12j. This is your answer for what? Change in momentum, that is kg meter per second. Hope this is the answer of the MCQ. In the very next MCQ, they have mentioned what is magnitude of this displacement. Magnitude is nothing but what? Magnitude, if somebody asks you to calculate, it is very simple. Very simple means, if somebody asks you the magnitude of change in momentum, that is delta P, that is equal to nothing but what? Under root of this first term square and second term square. You have to remove ij. 0.9 square plus point minus 0.12 square. Minus 0.12 square. Clear? So 9 square is my 0.81 and 0.1, that is 1.44. Check how much it would be. It's 1.44. So we are going to add, that is 5, 4 and 8 is 12, 2.25, and 2.25 is nothing but how much? 0.15, I can say. 15 are what? 225? 225 by 40. No, it will be 1.5, I think so. 1.5, 15 are 225. Yes or no? It's 100. So 10, answer is 1.5. So your change in momentum, that is going to be 1.5 unit kg meter per second. This is the final answer. Hope you are clear with concepts. We'll see more concepts into next chapter. Thank you so much. Here I am ending the video. We'll see more concepts into detail in the next revision session of this chapter. Clear? Thank you so much.